avid reader. I've got millions of books in my house. I breathe them. I've got books at my dad's place. I've got books at my place. My study is a cave of books. So it's really hard to answer a question like that. But I have to say one of my favorite writers is Kiran Nagarkar, and he's here. And he signed my books and he wrote my name on my books. And so they're going to be my most prized possessions. Certainly, it's strange because I read his Kukol when I was very young. I was maybe 15 or 16, and that's longer, like too long a way to even think about. And it's amazing because each scene, each battle scene, the scenes between the king and Mirabai, they've just stayed with me. So I love him for his detail and for his humor, because he's woven in humor in such a beautiful way, and he uses different levels of humor. There's, you know, right from the very naughty to the subtle. He uses humor as a great device and he uses it beautifully. So he is certainly a huge influence in my life. Another writer who I, again, maybe, I'm sorry Kiran Nagarkar, but maybe I love him a little more than I love you, is Roald Dahl. Roald Dahl is, I've read each and every one of his books. If he was, there was one writer in this world I could choose and I could write like, it would be him, because he's got a feel for language. Each of his books is so enjoyable to read aloud. It's easy, it just trips off your tongue, and it's full of humor and exciting words. So anything by Roald Dahl, really. This is turning into more of a conversation about authors than books, but I tend to find that if I love one book, then I love every other book by the same author. So certainly Roald Dahl has been a huge influence. A third one is a woman called Rebecca Wells, who you may have heard of, the Divine Secrets of the Yaya Sisterhood, and that's been turned into a movie. She's used the same clan and book after book about the same clan. And so Rebecca Wells is another great author to read. I would hate to call her a women's author, although most of her books are about women protagonists, but it's just wonderfully written. One of the scenes that stays with me is she writes about there's a letter from the boyfriend to Siddhali. Siddhali is the main character in The Divine Secrets of the Yaya Sisterhood. And all he writes about is this petal opening. And it's so erotically written. I mean, what genius to be able to do that. So these are my three. I really eat stuff. On a rainy day, it's definitely time for me to take out maybe an Amitabh Ghosh book. If I'm feeling cerebral, sometimes I've even reread a lot of Advaita Kala. I've reread my Anuja Chauhan's on a rainy day. It depends on what kind of rainy day it is, but I reread stuff. I don't read a book I haven't read before when I'm feeling gloomy. Summer break is murder. I love murder mysteries. I love Joe Nesbo, and I love Chevy Stevens, and I love blood and gore, and summer's perfect for that. Well, right now I'm reading Meera Sayal. I'm rereading Life Is Not It's Not All Ha Ha, and that's keeping me awake at night. I have to force myself to go to sleep to do that. Make a terrible day better. My book. I would recommend them a book. They don't deserve something so good. Go and, I don't know, die. Lucky you. Read. It's such a great time when people are writing, and there's so many books. We live in India where books are so much cheaper. Our libraries are affordable. They're well stocked. Lucky you. A comic character, Betty Boop, yeah, for sure, Klondike Kate.